Hi, how you doing?
Hello.
Joel, nice to meet you.
Dennis.
Nice to meet you. How are you going?
Not too shabby, not too bad. How are you?
I'm very well.
Can I get you a drink at all?
I would love a bone dry, dirty Plymouth martini if I can.
Yep, coming right up.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. So what do you do?
So I'm a bartender at night.
No way, you work hospitality as well?
Yeah.
I work hospitality too.
Really? Whereabouts?
So I work in Surrey Hills.
In Surrey Hills, the same. I work on Oxford Street.
Where do you live?
Over in Waterloo, so.
Same.
Oh, okay, what a small world.
It's like the gay hub of Sydney other than Oxford Street.
Well, I mean, I always say it's gay Mecca. Like,
gay Mecca. That's brilliant.
I noticed you have hearing aids in.
Yeah.
What's going on there?
Good question. I was diagnosed with bilateral hearing loss at the end of year 12.
What does that mean exactly?
The same amount of hearing loss in both ears.
Right, okay.
So up until like the age of 18, I didn't actually know that trees made the sound of noise, of like in the wind. I had no idea about that. And I didn't hear it. Like there was a whole plethora of sounds, like air conditioning noises, I didn't hear that.
Not being able to listen and pay attention to people can be quite hard. I've developed my own natural lip reading, which can be very tiring.
Employment-wise, it's been very difficult for me.
Some people just like to see you for that little flaw that I have within myself, and not actually see you for the person that you truly are.
I think the biggest thing that I have found solace in is being unconditionally myself.
That's so inspiring.
How was growing up?
Well, it was sufficient. I'm grown. I literally didn't even come out to my family. My mum was like, you're gay, right? And I was like, yep.
Just came out of the womb and you're like, yes, queen. So your parents must have been very accepting of you then.
Yeah, very accepting. My mum is my best friend in the entire world. She's such a beautiful woman. She's been burnt so badly by what my dad did.
Ooh, spicy.
But I'm fairly certain my dad had a midlife crisis and then completely ditched me, my mum, and my brother. I do feel bad for saying it because he's a really, really good dad in the sense that he's always there for me when I need him.
You just wish that.
That doesn't mean that he can't be held accountable for being a douchebag in the past.
I agree 100%.
Do you have a good relationship with your dad?
That's a joke.
Oh, really? Is it bad?
Well, I came out of the closet and he called me a donut puncher. And then I had to live with my auntie for like a couple of days.
So how's your guys' relationship today?
He usually asks my mum how I'm going. So then he doesn't have to ask me directly. I mean, he's pretty much ashamed of me in every other aspect.
Dennis, what makes you think he's ashamed of you?
Just the simple fact of the way how he treats me around his friends and the rest of his family. He tells me to be quiet, tells me not to speak about myself. And I think that's the biggest reason.
Oh my God.
Break my heart.
But yeah, it breaks mine too. I can't even begin to feel the pain he must have been through. What have you done? Poor Dennis. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. That's
all right. Horrible.
Oh, good. Okay.
That's you. Okay, moment of truth. Would you like to go on a second date?
Yes.
Yes. Sure.
I had such a nice time with you. Of course I'll go on a second date.
Oh, I'd love that.
How could we not?
I mean, we did have a really great connection.
I loved your warmth. I loved your vulnerability and how special it was that you shared such a moment with me that was clearly something that's very close to you. I really appreciated that.
Thank you for such a lovely night.
I had an amazing night.
I can't believe that we actually hit it off so much.
Yeah.
This is so cool, right?
Very much so, yeah, yeah.
So cool. Perfect. Are we skipping? Come on.
I mean, we can skip.